To me, the most amazing insect on planet Earth is the worker honeybee. Yes, honeybee colonies have the charismatic queen. You've got this large bee laying eggs. Beekeepers can select and breed queens. Yes, you have the lazy bum drone that's large and exists only to mate. But there's something special about the worker honeybee. She's behaviorally diverse. She's capable of doing so many things in the nest. And what's remarkable about this diversity of behavior in worker bees is that they could have been queens. Remember, queens lay two types of eggs, fertilized eggs and unfertilized eggs. These unfertilized eggs result in drones, the male honeybees. Fertilized eggs, on the other hand, result in female bees. And depending on the amount and quality of food that the worker bees feed to those developing female larvae, you'll get either queens or workers that result. Queen larvae get lots of high quality food, worker larvae get less lower quality food, and that's what makes queens and workers. Workers could have been queens could have been workers. Had that female developed into a queen, her most complicated behavior would be going out to mate, followed by the second most complicated behavior of putting her head into a cell and deciding what type of egg to lay. But on the other hand, diet made that female larva a worker. The worker, as the name implies, is the individual in the nest who contributes the most amount of effort to the movement of that colony. They're the ones with the most diverse behavioral suite. They are the most populous of the three types of bees in the nest. Colonies are composed of 95 to 99% workers, thousands of them, sometimes up to 40,000. And because of that, their magnificence is often lost in their numbers. But make no mistake, they are probably the most amazing insect that we have on Earth. Why is that the case? Well, when a queen lays an egg that's fertilized and becomes a female, and the workers start treating that larva as if they want it to be a worker, that individual will develop in about 3 weeks. Workers develop from egg to adult in 3 weeks. And when that worker emerges from her cell as an adult bee, she's not born into a task in which she remains her whole life. Instead, worker honeybees subscribe to this behavioral system called temporal polyethism. Temporal means time, poly means many, and ethism or ethos means behavior. Temporal polyethism, timed, many behaviors. As a worker ages, she progresses fairly predictably from task to task to task. Beekeepers tend to call this age-related division of labor. So when a worker bee emerges from her cell, she does what young worker bees do. They clean cells. And as they age, they progress into the next series of tasks that involve taking care of the brood or tending the queen. From there, as they age, they're capable of producing wax to develop that hexagonal infrastructure in the nest that's used as a brood area or as a storage space or as a communication matrix. From there, the worker moves to other complex behaviors that ultimately put them at the entrance of the nest, where they serve as guard bees. And as they age further still, they become the foragers in the nest, where they leave the nest to collect either water or plant rosins or nectar or pollen. Workers may live 6 weeks in summer and 6 months in winter. Behaviorally diverse, physiologically diverse, a masterpiece of insect engineering. Workers are how colonies exist. Workers make the collective decision of the colony. When it's time to swarm, workers make that decision. When they're ready to produce new queens, workers make that decision. When they want to produce drones, they will take those unfertilized eggs that the queen is laying and carry them through to adulthood. When they don't, they abort those eggs. Worker bees clean the nest. Worker bees remove the disease, the sick, and the dying. Worker bees make the food that's in the nest, and with glands in their head, they feed the offspring of the queen. Workers have forfeited the right to reproduce, to take care of their own developing sisters and brothers. Remarkable, remarkable series of behaviors, a remarkable bee. Worker bees engage in this defensive behavior where they protect the nest. They can feed one another. They have a complex dance and pheromonal communication system that communicates to their sisters exactly what they want to tell them. Food sources over here. We need to attack this intruder over there. We need to feed the brood at this point. Engineers, architects, guard, nurses, they have it all wrapped up into this neat little package called the worker honeybee.